Welcome all, it's Russ. And in this video, we're going to talk about iterating over collections instead of iterating over ranges of integers. In the previous video, I showed you that you could say for I in range 100, which would make I equal to 0, and then 1, and then 2, and then 3, all the way down the line. But it turns out that this syntax for variable in something is actually a general purpose syntax that you can use with lots and lots of Python data types. This is where Python really starts to shine, in my opinion. So what if we say x equals, all of these markers are getting a little weak. I might switch colors. X equals input. All right, so we're going to read one line of input from the character from the keyboard. Now, I already showed you something where we could say for I in range len of x, which would iterate over integers, which were the valid indices into x. So if it's, you know, 5 characters long, it would go 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's great if you need to know what the indices are. But very often, with a lot of things that you are doing, you don't need to keep track of what the indices are. What you can say is I want to iterate over x itself. So we'll change our variable name. You know, let's use I for iterator variables, c to represent the character. And now what do we print? Print C. So this will read from the input, then it will iterate through the string, assign C to each element in the string, and then print each one out one per line. What about with arrays? Can you do it? Yes, you can do the same thing with arrays. X equals 10, 20, 30. For V in X. Why do I call it V? V meant value, whatever. You'll notice that this is the exact same syntax. For variable in collection. For variable in collection. Print V. So this will print 10 and then 20 and then 30. Very, very cool. Can you do that over tuples? Yes, no change whatsoever. Can you do it over dictionaries? Yes, you can. You can do a loop over a dictionary. X equals 1A, 2B, 17C. Now, if you say for K in X, print K, what will this print? It will print 1, 2, 17. When you do a for loop over a dictionary, what you get is the keys of the dictionary. All right. Well, what if you want the values as well? Print x sub k. And now it will print 1. And then it prints A, then it will print 2, and it'll print B, and then it'll print 17, and then it'll print C. Something to note about this, when you iterate over a dictionary, you may sometimes get keys in the order you don't expect. I For simplicity here, I said, well, we're going to go 1, 2, 17. That's not really what happens. It could be almost any order. There is actually, if you get down in the guts of things, there is a particular order things happen. But I'm not going to try to explain to you what that is. So maybe you would get key 2 first. And after, so when you print key 2 and then you print its value, you'd print B. Then maybe you get 1 and then you print its value, which is A. Then you get 17 and you print its value, which is C. So when you iterate over a dictionary, you cannot assume that the keys arrive in any particular order. So just beware of that. If we have something where it really matters that you get things in the right order, then you're going to need to plan that out somehow about how you're going to control it. Maybe you want to look ahead to the video where we talk about sorting, because you could say, I'll just write it here. Sorted of x dot keys. I'm not going to show you what sorted does yet. We'll get to that in that other video. But I'll say that x dot keys is just a method that says go to the dictionary and get its keys as a collection that we can then pass into other structures. All right, so we can iterate over strings. I should tell you, by the way, this fact that dictionaries may arrive out of order, it's only true with dictionaries in the data structures I've shown you so far. So in strings, in arrays, and in tuples, these loops will always be in order. It's only dictionaries that get a little crazy. And there are some deep reasons for why that is. I don't have time to explain right now. All right. Anything else you can iterate over? Well, yes. Here's something that you might not expect. F equals open n dot for line in F. We've just opened a file. We open the file in.txt. We're now iterating over it as if it's a collection. What do you think are the elements of a collection when you're iterating over a file? Well, the way Python does this is that each one will be a line of the file. So if we have that example file I showed you earlier of dad, mom, Russ, Ben, then on the first iteration of the loop, line will be dad, new line, so it's a 4-character string, then it'll be mom, new line, then it'll be Russ, new line, then it'll be Ben, new line. So remember I told you that you can do sort of the equivalent of read line, but in a loop? That's what this does. This is the equivalent of calling read line over and over and over and over and over again until you hit the end of the file. So we could say print the line, or we could process it, or whatever we wanted to do. And then we remember at the end of our function to close our file object before we forget about it. All right, so that is for loops over collections. You're going to find yourself using this all the time in Python. It's just amazing how often you do it, that you're trying to do a loop over a collection. So, hope it's been useful. Hope you've learned a lot, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.